Hello everyone, so we are doing IBPS PO and clerk preparation video series, and this is the second video of the series. If you haven't watched the first one, I would recommend you to go and have a look at that. So I have watched a few comments that people are struggling especially with quants. So in this video, I'll talk about the detailed strategy for quantitative aptitude. So in quantitative aptitude, whenever I talk about something, I always talk about two aspects of it. First one is the efforts you are putting to increase the knowledge in that subject. But the second one, I consider it more important, which is about the mindset, which is the belief system you have to develop during this whole of your preparation stage or even in life. So belief system is very, very important. So first thing I would want to talk about is the belief system. So you, unless you believe that it is possible, it won't be possible, right? So first thing is that you have to believe, aapko believe karna padega, that no matter how weak I am at some subject, maybe it is quant, English, reasoning, or even GA, right? So unless you do not believe, it won't happen. So belief system is the first thing. But the question is that how we can develop this belief system. So belief system is nothing but pushing yourself always towards the positivity, right? No matter how distract you are, you have to you have to do some self-talks straight away to remove that distraction. Second is that you have to believe in your efforts, right? If you are doing something, definitely it will result in something, right? If you are doing it in right direction, definitely right results will come, right? So it is very important for you to develop that belief system slowly and gradually, right? So belief system is the first thing that I have talked, and without belief system, no matter how much efforts are you are putting, it will not work, right? So second thing is the particular quant thing that I want to talk to. So we should start with, see, there are some prerequisites that you have to do. Aapko prerequisites wo karne padenge. Wo kya hai? You have to remember these things by heart. What are these things? These things are tables up to 30, squares up to 30, sorry, cubes up to 30 and square up to 50. And you should also know how to find squares of bigger numbers than 50. Right. So this is it. And also you need to remember the percentages to fraction up to, like, you have to remember from 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4 up to 1 by 25, right? So it will help you in data interpretation as well as in quant. If you do remember these 3-4 things that I have told you, you will see that half of your confidence has already improved as far as quant is concerned. But some people say that we remember but we forget it. So what should we do? So it is very important for you to wake up and write these things on your copy, no matter how good you are at it. But you have to write daily these things, so that at some point you will feel that it is fit into your mind and you need not to write it again. So I have done it for like 2-3 months. Now I remember everything that I have told you. So it is very important that you do these things very, very passionately and religiously, right? So first thing is this. Second thing is that you have to do some basics, right? So first of all, maths is not tough. Nothing is that tough. If it was tough, we would not do it, right? We only do easy things. So maths is So you all know that in competitive exams, only elementary mathematics is being asked, right? So for that, I would suggest you to watch some video, like pick one topic and watch video for that. Watch such video in which all the concepts are crystal clear. My favorite on YouTube is Sumit Verma sir, and you can also watch classes of Ashish sir, but I would recommend you to not watch long 2-3 hours of classes, but just search that topic on YouTube and watch a few videos of that topic, right? That's it, and then come back to the questions. Now the second step is you have to do 200 to 300 questions. This bunch of questions will improve your confidence, right? Even if you are slow at start, that is not a problem. It happens with everyone. You cannot put your bike from first to fourth gear at once, right? You have to go through the second and third gear, and then you go to the fourth one, right? So first thing is clear your basics from YouTube. You do not need to have a paid course unless you are a very distracted person, right? So first is YouTube, second is solve a bunch of questions. Third thing which is very important, that some people say that they do one topic and they forget it after 2-3 days, but how we should memorize it, or we should do it strong. So the idea is to revise these things. So first thing is that YouTube videos. Second thing is that 200 to 300 questions from anywhere, from any PDF. You do not need a book even. You can use any PDF, or you can use anything. I mean, from where you can get questions of that topic. If you want to solve book, I would suggest you to solve fast track arithmetic by I think it's Rajesh Verma, right? So that book is a good book. Why I'm keeping it above RS Agarwal is just because in RS Agarwal there are like thousands of questions of every type, right? So it is very important for you to utilize the time and do not do a lot questions, but yes, do decent number of questions and then come back to your mocks and all, right? So it is all the types have been covered in that book. So if you are a beginner, you can solve that, right? So third thing is that you should revise every third or fourth day the concepts you have read, right? And solve 10 to 15 questions, right? So this is the third thing after clearing your basics. And for every topic, you need to do this revision exercise for 3-4 times, right? So even on the 15th day, you have to do the things you have done on the day one, right? What else? After clearing your basics, just after 10 to 15 days, you should start the daily things. If you have cleared your basics already, then you should start right away from the daily things. I have already made a video on what you should do daily to improve your marks in banking. In banking quants, right? So quantitative aptitude is not that tough in banking, because at least in prelims you know that what is going to come in the exam. So when you know that this is going to come, then we should really work hard on it, and we should do it daily so that it become a cakewalk for all of us, right? The main problem comes in mains. So after you have to do daily things, and then for mains you really have to put some extra efforts in the data interpretation. So I would I would highly recommend you to keep your basics and concepts strong for the things which are going to help you in mains. So data interpretation and the chapters associated with the data interpretation, like percentages, profit and loss, ratio proportion, and a few more things. You have to do these chapters very firmly, so that it also helps you in mains exam. Mains, after talking about prelims, mains the quant subject is getting tougher every day, but the good news here is that when the exam gets tougher, the cutoff goes down. So last year the cutoff was like 3 or 4 or 5, maybe 5.25 to be exact. So it is certain that you can score that 5.25. I have scored like 15 to 16 marks in, or maybe 14 marks in quant. All you have to do is that in those 45 minutes of mains exam of quant, you have to find the doable questions. If you are strong at some kind of data interpretation, it is going to be a cakewalk for you to clear the sectional cutoff, and you do not have to fear, because you will make your GA and English so strong that you will clear the exam with flying colors, right? So I have told you that in DI you have to do some mental calculation, and you have to make these percentages and ratio proportion very strong. So it will help you in DI. The last thing is that when you attempt a mock quant section in a mock, try to stick to a sequence, right? What I used to stick to is that I used to finish simplification, approximation, these kind of quadratic equation, these kind of things very fast. And how I made it very fast is just because of the daily things that I was doing. Then make these things so fast that you can get some time for arithmetic questions as well. And do not forget to do 5 questions from 3 different chapters every day with the daily things. 5 questions from 3 different arithmetic topics. This way you will keep yourself intact with the concepts. And the last and the most important thing is that if you are clearing your basics now, I would highly recommend you to make some short notes of your formulas and all, but make sure that you are not downloading it from anywhere. Do write it in your own words, do write it in your own notebook, so that this is the best way to revise things fast. So when the exam comes near, you can just go to that notebook and revise very fast and boost the confidence in just 6 seconds, like Eno works. So that's all about quant. The last thing I would add is that I would want to summarize it. First is that you should believe in yourself, because there are a lot of superpowers in you that you do not know. When you start believing yourself, that magic unfolds by itself. Second thing is that do the prerequisites that I have told you. Third is that clear your basics. Fourth thing is that for mains you need to work more on DI and the chapters associated with it. Fourth thing is that when you attempt a mock, do have a firm strategy. Yes, you can do some experiment at the start, but after giving 7 to 8 mocks, you should have a firm strategy which has really worked for you, and you can use that strategy in the exam itself. And last thing I want to tell you is that be fearless. be very, very fearless while you attempt a mock, while you be very, very cheerful. Have a smile on your face always. It always helps. It helped me a lot. And that's it. Anything is possible. And if you have some doubt, you can post it in the comments. I would surely take it in the next video. And yes, if you like the content, do like, comment, share, subscribe, anything you want. And that's it. Thank you very much.